harvesting rights of 1.2 million acres of state forestry, the people's forests, to pay off the debts of bankers is an act of national sabotage and betrayal. Public ownership of the forests and the trees that stand on them is the birthright of Irish citizens. And I don't know, Minister, if the word treason has its roots in the word trees, but to sell off the state forestry is an act of treason. What you are planning to do has been done by no other country in Europe. Only one country, Sweden, sold off some of its state forestry and a few years later quickly took it back into 100% public ownership. In Britain, Cameron's Britain, when it was proposed they would sell off the state forests, there was a public outcry after a widespread public consultation and the plans were abandoned. Here, of course, there's been no public consultation. And no wonder, because if you did do a public consultation with the stakeholders and the people who care about our forests, they would tell you that privatisation puts at risk thousands of jobs, both direct and indirect, in the forestry sector, that all valuations so far that have been done for the state forestry lands are gross undervaluations, which suggests that we're going to be selling off the land, the harvesting rights for about 500 or less euro per acre, when agricultural land in this country goes for about 2,000 or 3,000 euro an acre. They would tell you that even under Coillte, forest assets are being sold to prop up the pension fund, the hole that is in the pension fund. How much more are we going to see our national forest assets stripped if private for profit and commercial interests take over the state forestry? Consultation would also tell you that because forests take 30 to 50 years to grow and rotate, that you need intergenerational, stable stewardship of forests.
Thank you, Deputy.
Of the sort that you cannot have when you're talking about speculators and profiteers running the forests. And they would tell you in New Zealand, where privatisation has taken place, there have been major problems of public access, job losses, outflow of profits out of the country. There is simply no justification to sell our forests, and you should abandon this plan immediately. And at the very least, you should have a public consultation where the facts of Irish forestry and the impact of its sale would mean for this country.
Margaret and Tara.